And then, yes, liquidy night, we said, okay, let's do it. And then you regretted it for the next 6 months, but it worked out. No, it wasn't as chaotic as I'm making it sound. You know, 2006, 2007 was an amazing time, and all of us will remember, every industry was growing. You had mobility, you had financial services, you had media, you had advertising, and for all of us employees, it was the best time because you had four options, each giving you a 50% jump on salary, right? So you either had an option of going into something like that, and at that time I also had another option internally from Pepsi to move into an international territory and run that territory, but it would have been a smaller country in comparison to India and doing more or less the same thing. This for me had two things which helped me take a decision. One, I looked at upon this as, you know, a risky but an opportunity to really become an entrepreneur with somebody else's money. And I had always wanted to do that, didn't have the money. So here there was an organization which was willing to back you and put some money on the table, which was great. It was a domain which I thought straddled media, entertainment and retail. So I thought, ki chalo karke dekhte hain. If nothing else, I might then expand my horizons and find a job in either media, entertainment and retail, which was my background. And third, with the tele shopping, it couldn't have got any worse, na? So if you did the job right, you would only hopefully change perception. So there were positives in the whole thing. But fundamentally, it was important for me to test myself as an entrepreneur, and I was driven by the fact that you needed to re-engineer your own skill set. And I think I'm again getting driven in that same domain, because having done this for 5-7 years, the market has changed. Our skill sets on digital are so different to what they were even 5 years ago. I'll give you a small example, and this is again people related. Supply chain. A classical role, very easily there are supply chain experts in the country, but I'm not being able to find one, because most supply chain guys come with the baggage of a B2B model. Supply chain is truckloads, distributor, wholesaler. In our case now, supply chain is an individual invoice and an individual product across 4,500 cities. So what kind of skill sets do you get? Analytics. Everyone's been talking about building BI and stuff like that. We've got all of that. But analytics is about finding a handful of good thinkers. It's about a few good guys who know how to decipher data with no historical background and yet be able to forecast. So it's again time to, at least for me, and I'm requesting part of the team also, to again unlearn and start learning and imbibe new skill sets.